I don't know how, for example, Graham or Dirk produce the work that they do. It's incredible. It's beautiful. And I don't really want to know either. They will talk about it in the same way, going, oh, well, actually, it was just a bit of water and some bubbles, and I stuck the camera in it, and that was it. That's pity.
The fact that we are multidisciplined has allowed lots of different types of propositions to come through our studio. A few people are prepared to take a chance, and as things have progressed, more and more people have taken a chance with working with us on things that perhaps traditionally we wouldn't or shouldn't work on.
Hello. Yeah. Come on then. Come on.
Come on.
Let's go and film. And now entering film, start set.
We're making the Stephen Hawking book is being made into a 6-part TV series, and we're creating the Big Bang and the growth of the universe out to the present day. Maybe at some point next week we'll touch on the future. We don't have a clue what we're doing. This is quite a sort of fairly unusual way for us to work, because usually we don't make models and things that are quite so elaborate. I mean, this whole situation today is really interesting, because it's we've got set parameters. We've defined some 10 things that we plan to do, but Graham and I are both trying to find ways of almost getting the crew and the cameraman to operate against the way that they normally do. You almost have to, half our work, I think, is getting people to forget the way they normally work. And to try something new. And it's that simple. That's great, thanks very much. Graham and I, when we work together, it's a very sort of... It's usually a lot of fun. It's a sort of quite a carefree process, but we try and make it as relaxing and as much fun as possible.
I think the one thing that is missing is comedy. I mean, I'd like it to come out much more. And because I just think it's just, you know, it's really essential. It's a really essential part of living, you know. For a while we were showing sort of 6 5-minute pieces to people that were all quite serious, and with the sound of wind going. And it was all quite sort of like, ooh. And but then we just suddenly thought, hang on a sec, there's something really important missing, which was what we are.
I tell you who you should really ask about that. That's John Warwicker.
Mm-hmm.
Get him to explain himself.
Yeah, John Warwicker was a member of Fru.
Many years ago, at the dawn of time, Rick and Karl had a band called Fruer. And I was also part of it. And it was great. was, in some ways, a precursor of what we were doing at Tomato. In fact, many of ideas that came out of that period are second nature to how we work within Tomato.
Conversations. I think people's conversations are amazing. Things people say still captivate me. And just walking around the streets, really. It's very surprising what you collect. It's just like going around the streets with a Hoover, and you empty the bag out at the end of the week and go, wow, some of this stuff is amazing. I don't write it, I just collect it.
The importance of the move to Tomato, to the new building, apart from space, you know, was to embrace the change, not to try and import what we had beforehand, because it's a different space. So that was Tomato, and this is now Tomato. But they're going to be different.
Valentine's Day message.
Shake it. Now what's that? Pushing this, holding this here.
For a man to woman or a woman to man. And it's for the website of Axis magazine. So it's a moving image, so we're just trying to do something that works on a loop.
All right.
Your legs in the way, Tom.
See this is good.
Can we have that sound effect? We quite like the quirkiness of that moving frame. Quite like the fact it's like a spring bed, actually.
More wine here.
I think a lot of our work is moving away from just being on a desk or on a screen or in a book or in a small format into more installation work. As our work between Tomato and Underworld become more and more fused and more together, and installations and areas and environmental things and architectural things is an obvious way that we're going to develop.
Because we want to go doing something like that way. So that'll be this way. So there's concentration form will start here.
Right.
Okay. So they're going to flip around the other way so it goes.
Yeah.
One, two, three, four, so it goes that way.
Okay.
Yeah.
No problem.
We were asked to do an exhibition in Prague, and the venue that we were given was a bunch of windows in the middle of the city. And basically, we had a choice of putting stuff inside behind the glass or doing something with the glass, and we came up with the idea of writing on the windows. And it's a really simple thing. It's a vinyl letters, and you write things and they appear on glass, which is great. Isn't it, Karl?
It's lovely.
Yeah.
Smashing.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. It's just nice to get you work out in this visible from the street, really. It's always been stuck away in files and in books and stuck away in places where most people can't get at it. And it's just very nice to be able to put that work out that's visible on from a street.
I think that, you know, that's probably one of the best things about it. It's not pretending to be anything other than what it is, which is some writing published in a different place.
The other thing that might be good is that when you get to, like, a different window, we get Rick to do some different sound effects.
Yeah.
I think with all the loops and things, it's
so become, each window becomes its own sound loop.
Yeah. Well, they should all work, you know, have their own identity.
The other thing that would be really nice is to continue that idea of that android voice.
What, reading?
Yeah, and actually reading back while you see the two things.
I was going to say, if you put it in as text anyway, and so that you can call it up as a hard thing if you want to.
Yeah,
it
on
sits
top
underneath
of it,
If you've got the four... That's Underworld and Born Slip. You're listening to Andrew Oliver, 94.9 GLR, sitting in for Sir Robert of Elm, who's up north, I believe, somewhere. So, a true design cooperative... Tomato have been redefining boundaries and style since 1991, apparently. And I am joined by Michael Horsham and Graham Wood, who are going to help me understand.
Well, you can help us understand it.
Really? Tell me about this. Where is it? The Royal Geographical Society.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, please! I promise to be nice.
It's there's this big thing, and on Wednesday night, I think it's probably sold out now, which has been organised by D&AD, who are sort of an awards stroke educational thing for the design and advertising industry. And where most of us are going to do something, a little bit of a party turn, some juggling and some... not really.
No juggling at all.
No juggling at all. Actually, extreme nerves. And sort
are you nervous?
Nervous, us?
Just babbling now.
I'm actually not performing it, so I'm just part of Tomato. I'm supporting...
We're going to show some films, we might talk. But what we're actually going to talk about, I've no idea at all.
I've been busy prior to Christmas and things, and I don't feel I've got anything at this moment to say.
I suspect people will fill the room and we'll talk, and hopefully people will laugh and think, wow, that's nice, and they'll clap and we'll go home and feel self-satisfied. I don't know. I think if we knew what we were going to do, it wouldn't be worth doing it, really.
You know, not everyone has got something to say all the time.
We do a lot of talks at colleges and stuff and things, and, you know, and the situations in which it works best is when, you know, you're just talking to anyone, whereas when it's for the industry, it's always a bit sort of like people turn up just to moan, really. They're going, what do they think they're standing there for, you know? And it's like, we'll be there because we've been asked to be there. It wasn't our idea, but again, we could have said no, I suppose.
First became aware of this unusual collective in 1993 when a commercial burst onto our television screen. And I was amused to read in an article recently, a couple of weeks ago, that a journalist accused our speakers of smuggling 30-second snatches of drugged-crazed dance groove into suburban living rooms. So I think we're in for a good evening. Ladies and gentlemen, Tomato.
Next, the latest international news from ITN.